Just skirting out of there.
Close enough.
Good Aether Remnant.
First
blood there for Yopash. Solo kill onto Ori.
And he just deals way too much damage to handle, even for a hero like Medusa.
And if you find yourself potentially silence unable to get that ult off, you can get shackled from such a distance away.
They look over
at ult 11. And they get the kill to the Bristleback. They're starting to chase. They've got a two-man Dreamcool coming in, as well as the silence on both of those track, as well as the Ogre Magi. They've got the shackle coming out for PYW. They get a kill on Jean Yuel, but they end up losing ult 11. This is not looking too great for Vici, though. They'll lose a second. PYW ends up going down to play hard.
How much in terms of
like time, I would say probably the most, is Death is getting chased here by old 11. Got the Inks as well, should be able to stun him up. They've got the silence as well from the Phantom.
Damage from the Bristle.
Grace. And this is a lot of damage from the Bristle, but it's taken a long time to even kill this Oshrak. Finally get a kill onto Death, but they got the stun onto the puck. They'll look over to at least trade old 11. Need a couple more
tanky
shots.
Though.
He's quite tanky. Duels up into the air, and old 11 does finally fall to Yopage. However, while that's happening, bottom, they're trying to take a tier 2 tower.
Yeah, lost the push coming in, but they're responding swiftly. UAW in trouble here.
Yeah, gets caught by that Aether Remnant, gets the Hex out onto Yopage. They're still trying to take
tower's
the tower.
Falling, though.
Focusing onto the tower, and we'll take it.
I mean, he knows they have no way to spin, cancel the spin TP. Yeah, because VG is doing a really good job at split pushing. You can see it, they're pressuring top, but they're already hitting mid tower. Potentially team fight. Yeah, Leshrac.
Ooh, very careful. They've got the Dreamcore coming in on a two. They've got the Leshrac as well as the Void Spirit Eels up into the air. As they'll use that Hex, do they have the control to get this kill? Here comes the Medusa, and there's the old Fuse turning it around on the PY. Don't even get the kill on the Shadow Shaman. Immediately into the Blade Fury is Boyoyo to get away. And set up to be something nice for VG. Can they get back in here and maybe turn this around? They get the kill on a Death. They'll take it to Leshrac. Phase shift into the Aether Remnant and just setting it up so easy as they'll take out Ori, and it ends up being a 2-for-1. This isn't exactly the fastest Rosh. Old 11 starting to step forward, but I don't know if that's the spot he wants to be in. They're already starting to chase the Bristle. He's got his back to the rest of the Radiant team and really not taking much damage overall. They've got the Shackle onto the Medusa for a second. We'll use that Stone Gaze, turn around on a PYW, get the kill there onto the Shadow Shaman. They turn this Bristle back to stone. That's a big problem here for Old 11. The Rolling Thunder comes in. They've got themselves the Dream Core that's going to snap out of the Ogre Magi as well as the Soul Mine. They've got themselves the Omni Switch. They get the kill to play hard as well as Jean Yuel. Now they're going to turn this around. They've only got three heroes available on the side of Neon, and they've caught themselves the Opage. Down goes the Void Spirit. It's a triple kill here for Poyoyo, and Old 11 is still not dead. I mean, this guy is showing him their back, showing him their front. He doesn't die.
Like some of the best hard carries in the game. Dusa, Juggernaut. Whoever takes it late game, they have a shot of winning. So no team is really on the clock here.
Going after Death and trying to catch up with him. Aether Remnant avoiding it. Still continuing to slow down this Leshrac, though. The question is how far do they want to commit? They know that Neon's got to be waiting for them. The Lotus Orb.
Auto damage to Bristle.
The turnaround. A lot of damage coming through onto the Bristleback. They've got themselves the Rolling Thunder coming in. But now Serpent Ward's placing a good
healing
spot
ward
to lock up this Medusa. And they've got the Healing Ward that's healing up Old 11 and letting them potentially turn this around. Omni Slash coming in. Is it going to be enough damage? It bounces over to Player. They get the kill here onto the Pangolier. They look over at the Leshrac. They drop the Dream Globe and it's locked onto Death. And he will find his death because he is dead and gone. Daniel also dies
after talking about.
Look at that shackle. Exactly what we were talking about, Black. And they are going to lock down Yopage, but can they lock him down long enough to get the kill?
One more
step,
bro.
Away. Aether Remnant placed down. Looking, searching into the trees. They've got him. Man, perfect from Vici, not losing anybody.
It's a total of 400% damage, so. I'm not very good at math, but that number is definitely bigger.
We all know how good my math
oh,
is.
Oh, he missed the Yules.
Oh, the Yules, but it's still enough to get the kill there. That's a little bit of a surprise as they start to maybe get old 11. However, they're going to lose Jean Yuel as Rolling Thunder comes through. PYW is still alive for the moment, but the Aether Remnant lands as well as the Rolling Thunder coming through on the PYW. They get the Thunder, the Shadow Shaman, and old 11 still looking to move forward. They've got the Omni Slide, Lotus Orb use as well as the Ghost Scepter. Blade Fury right on top of Death. They will kill off the Leshrac. Damage done to old 11, but every time I talk about him, it feels like he's not dying. And
back.
As I say that, I jinx it.
Triple
coil. Coil on a three. And now Vici, it's back and forth. It's in and out. They're trying to find an answer here. Omni Slash ends up getting used. Poyoyo trying to get the kill here onto the Medusa. And he's got the Swift Slash. They'll get the kill onto Nabil. They'll take out Play Hard. Triple kill for Poyoyo. Can they make it one more? Astral step away from Yopage. He gets out of the fight for now and will escape with his life.
Is really fast and it's react. They're still kind of just chilling. They probably want to go in as Roche is already dead. They're not going in.
Oh, Aegis picked up by Puyoyo. Illflash was trying to make a play here. They've got the Hex, and now can they get the
Long
kill
arms
here onto the Void Spirit? They've got the Shackle that should be able to get the kill here on Illflash, and they'll finish him off. Now the Druko comes out onto both of the Shrek as well as the Ogre Magi. His old 11's going to be on the higher ground once again. They've got the Stone Gaze, but do they have the damage to get a kill onto old 11? It's not looking likely, but as I say that,
slash.
He's bounced into the air twice by Playhard, and finally they finish off old 11. They fall back
Omni
on
slash.
Illflash. Here comes the Omni Slash. It's coming all the way through. They got the kill onto Januel. They end up losing DY as well as old 11 to 2-0 stand on the side of Vici, and now down goes the Beal. Blade Fury right on top of Death, and Death, I've said it before, I'll say it again, he has found his Death. Triple kill, that's like the fifth time he's got a triple kill.
Yeah. Ori is, and always has been, one of the... Oh! Hex initiation.
Oh, Ogre caught, Shackle, Swoop Slash coming through, there's the kill, and now the Rolling Thunder as well as the Blink Tiger, they're gonna go forward on a PYW, they use the Invisible Blade coming out of the Death, they've got the Soulbind that's gonna lock him up over on the Playheart, so he's not gonna be spinning anywhere, they've got the Serpent Ward drop down as well as the Dream Cloak coming down on three of these heroes, they're trying to get the kills on the side of Neon, they've already taken out PYW with BKB Pop on
Medusa.
Look at old 11, he's just moving forward, they've got the kill on the Death, they'll take out Yopaj, they'll look over at Playheart, they fought back on the Death, but Death, I'm not sure he's got enough here to really turn this around for Neon, they're gonna chase past the tier 4s. They'll get the kill on a play hard. That's going to be 3 dead. They do have buyback available on this Pangolier, but it is not looking likely that Neon are going to get out of this one.
Hitting 1 on 30, no buyback on 2 of the heroes.
Abyssal use on the Medusa in trouble. Lotus Orb is going to be enough to save. It's not looking likely. He's already out of mana. He's already out of life, and he's not got much for it.
GG!
GG is right, Black. Vici take game 1 over Neon. And that is just a kick in the door and a kick in the teeth there from Vici. If they can meet at the right times, which we were seeing from Vici with two other supports, obviously, with the TPs and the timings, then I could see it happen. But right now, they're going to just go with the puck as well as this Spirit Breaker.
Genuous
and all of a sudden, he's just gone. Like, they use that Dream Coil, they charge in, and it's under the Tier 1 tower. The immediate rotations from Vici are there to stop this from really being a problem. And Pango... he's finding himself low, not dead, but this is all of a sudden thin ice for Neon in this mid lane. They're really trying to make something happen over mid.
They finally
get it done with the Wrath of Nature.
Yeah, this Gyrocopter is, he's a decent catch-up hero. He's even maxing Fly Cannon to just make sure that he can farm as well as possible. Ori actually getting picked off here on the bottom lane.
Yopaj getting the kill over bottom, and now they're looking for more. They're trying to get this Alchemist. This is exactly what I was talking about. Slow down this Axe, and that could become a problem for the side of Vici.
Trouble.
They've gotten on top of this Nature's Prophet. They hit the sleep on a 2. They do take out old 11, but they're going to lose Deville here. That is not someone you want to be losing at the moment. And again, trying to get into the Rolling Thunder, but the stun comes out from the Nyx Assassin. They'll use that charge.
Double
they've got
puck.
A bash out on a Puyoyo, and with the help of Yopaj, they'll get another kill.
And they're gonna be in trouble here. Like, he will have to choose between either the Void Spirit or the Gyrocopter. They both need the Axe badly. He can only give it to one of them. They have
Void
Rolling Thunder.
Again. He's gonna try and Rolling Thunder in. They've got the Timber Saw to try and help Death move
no
forward.
Steps.
Can they land a sleep? Ooh, all right, two-man sleep. But I still think they're right on top of this Void Spirit. They need to be careful how much they're gonna commit for this. Or, well, Death doesn't. It's only the Pango who really needed to, is they'll get the kill onto Ori, look for PYW,
coil.
They use the Dream Coil. They're behind the Tier 2! It's 12 minutes in!
They're even stealing the Ancient Stack. Everything is going wrong for them. The Wido?
This is just
not
what you want to be seeing for Vici. Aether Remnant? They got him!
Nice. But they lost Puyoyo in return. Agon's finished. It's probably going to go to Void Spirit. They really need to make sure it pays off.
They'll find PYW once again, and this is a big problem for the Elder Titan. Out
is
comes
it?
Over. I'm not sure what he's going to do here. They've got the Timber Saw joining in. Spike Carapace doesn't turn into anything. Ooh, good two-man stun. Puyoyo comes back into the fight, gets a kill into Januel, but the Timber Saw, do they have the damage to kill him? Astral Step across the bow as well, to assimilate right on top of him. Rolling Thunder coming in. They had the Whirling Death. Hit on a couple of these heroes.
Puyoyo dead again?
Puyoyo once again, and they will take out old 11. This is really falling apart of the seams here for Vici as they're
triple
gonna lose
four.
DY, triple kill for Deville. And I mean, Ori can only play Ring Around the Rosie. It seems like eventually he's gonna get caught. He will get a kill on Yopaj, but does he end up surviving getting back to the base? Death just trying to take a tier 2 up towards top, has some help from the Treants. And charging. Yeah. Dream Coil used. Can they snap the coil? Of course, a charge, 17%. That equals 100%. Not skill at all. I don't know what that would be. Just a guy who plays the game.
Well, the charge is coming through here. He does have ultimate as well. Good impale.
Good stun. That's going to save Koyoyo for a little bit longer, but I don't know if it's going to save his life completely. The
Thunder
coming in as well as Yopaz trying to come through. Aether Remnant lands on a Dabil. He's in a little bit deep, but it's not going to matter. They get the gun to the gyrocopter. They look over at the nature prop. They get the kill. They'll end up making a trade. Earth Splitter hits, but it's not doing enough. Charging all the way through onto Ori as well as the ult. Good stun coming out from DY once again. They're trying to push back the Neon side, who is continuing to jump further and further down the throats of Vici. The question is, can Vici spit him out? They get the kill to play hard, and now, PYW ends up falling. Januel, can he get out of this? I think he can. I don't know if Vici really want to chase. They don't feel comfortable in these fights at all.
Yeah, that being said though, the fight was quite good for them. Prophet TP'd in way too aggressively, gets taken out immediately. He doesn't have... Oh, another Dream Call, the only Alchemist.
Oh no, old 11 once again. He's caught out. He threw him to lands out of the Timber Saw. That's not who you want. You want to play hard, but you're not going to get him.
DY out
to help out this
here.
Void Spirit. And look at the damage still coming in from both Yopaj and Dabil. They're going to get another one. And now that will cover PYW. Yopaj is behind the tier 2 tower again. Johnny will end up surviving. They've got the Chakram thrown out. Death now pushing even further onto the Dire side. Top. And that's going to leave him vulnerable. Januel needs to get into the trees, try and find himself out of vision, but it's not happening. They'll get the kill here, and it will be for old 11.
They're all rotating in. There's a lot of potential for a really big coil here.
They're looking to charge up that stun. They've got the Astro Scent moving forward. Leopage setting up. He's got a two-man Dream Coil coming through on old 11 as well as Poyoyo. Looking over his Timber Chain across the bow of this Jungle. Once again, they might have the damage to finally kill off this Timber Saw, and they do! It's PYW gets the kill, but Poyoyo falls once again. Yopaj cleaning him up. The Rolling Thunder coming in as well as the Swashbuckle, but Play Hard.
There's the Prophet.
Really hit with that Swashbuckle. They've got the Aether Remnant, the lockdown Play Hard, getting that kill into the Pangolier, and again, it's fight after fight from Neon. They want to go for this. They've got the smoke. They're going to stun up, or charge up the stun on the Alchemist. They've got the Aether Remnant as well.
It's a lot of damage.
The Impale, the Earth Splitter. Look at the damage coming into the Death, but it's not going to be enough. They've got the charge coming into the Alchemist. Old 11, he just melts. Dream Coil lands on it too. It's on to both the Nyxus as well as the Elder Titan. They're going to get the kill here on a DY. They'll finish off PYW. But it is something.
What map? They have no map.
Yeah. Aether Remnant. Look at the damage come out onto Play Hard. Charge over, though. They're going to try and get a trade here onto Ori. Gets low, he's not dead just yet. Waning Rift as well as Yopaj just trying to get a kill here.
And it might be even helping them to alleviate some of the pressure.
Dream Coil coming through
Prophet
onto
TP in.
Ori. They've got the Prophet TP in. Did he get it perfect? Yeah, with the Yules, but I don't know if that's even going to be enough. It's impressive from Ori, but still lacking what he needs to escape from that situation. And it's hard as it is with a puck in your face.
Gyrocopter again
they're
here.
Immediately onto Poyoyo. They're going to pop this BKB.
Getting bashed.
And clips himself, and it's only a cosplay for a second of Cliff Teasy. They will get the kill out of Poyoyo. The Rolling Thunder comes out, and that's going to land onto DY. They've got the Timber Chain as well as the damage to follow it up of all five heroes to kill off DY and get to. Close. Not caught, though. Ooh, I say that. But now they've got the Rogue Thunder coming in as well as the charge. The Impel's going to land on the Spirit Breaker, but look at the stuns coming through. That hits on both the Nyx Assassin as well as the Alchemist. They're getting the cone to hold 11 as
good
well as
coil.
The Coil landing on both the Void Spirit as well as the Gyrocopter. Poyoyo as well as Ori need to be careful, but... So they back off a little bit, giving Vici maybe an opening to go for something. They're going to ask for stuff as well as the Aether ending onto the Spirit Breaker, but... Ooh, not landing everything. However, they'll still get the kill. Got Dream Coil available, and that just comes through on a three. That's going to land. They've got the kill.
Yopaj no phase shift.
Previous fight. Yopaj, he's got himself silenced, but he ends up phase shifting. Is he gone? He'll blink away. He'll lose Reorb as well. And while that's happening, Poyoyo and Old 11, they're both killed off, and they found themselves Ori. It looks like it's going to be a fourth. He'll try to dissimulate. He'll try to Astral Step. The Illusory Orb over with the dag, and the shield crash right on top of him.
They should be trying to end this game.
Yeah, up 32,000.
A lot of damage on
throw that stun out, and again, Death not dead, gets the Guardian Greaves off. How many times are we going to watch this story? Because it feels like it's been on repeat for the last couple of weeks. They will not kill off Death, but they will finish off
Malilio.
They'll look towards the rest. Bomb back here on the gyro coming to go into the Void Spirit. Ori up into the air with the Yules, but Death is right on top of him, using that Timber Chain to get the kill. They'll end up taking out Ori. They'll buy back on this Void Spirit. Death low once again, and now we'll finally lose that Aegis, but it's just the Aegis. They're up 40k. They're looking to reinitiate once they've got their Timber Saw back up. Look at the damage coming in from Death, or coming in onto Death once again. He's low once more, but still not dying. I've said it four, I've said it five, maybe six times about this Timber Saw. He will not go down again, and they will call GG.
GG!
Even at one.
Again. So well played by Neo. Damn. 40k gold lead.
One support here, one support there, but these teams, especially Vici, they're really
Lord briefcase.
And oh, there's the right click, Shanuel, first blood coming through on old 11. They'll take out the Pango, that extra damage. Shard's just a bit off, and DY able to gallop away on that horse. However, now this is left to Beal by himself over bottom. They'll get the kill into the Lashrak, and that's what happens when your supports rotate over mid. He's still got two down bottom.
But as I say that, their supports don't really add any teamfights at all. Good coil. Easy kill.
They've leashed him up. They'll look for the sleep. They've got Death coming in, and they'll get the kill. Yopaj getting credit for that one on an old 11.
They're smoking it anyway. They can't fight this without the Pango, I think.
They're going to try to. Death standing still, just trying to get a D ward, and now looking to make his way out. He's not going to be successful with that.
Water
he
off.
Stayed too long at a decent pace. He's got to keep it up, though, and with the map shrinking and shrinking, it may not be that easy. They've got a ward on the high ground. The smoke breaks. They're going to know exactly where they are. They've got the sight as well as the Searing Chains. Power Shot comes in and a play hard Remnant forward. Snowball, though, staying alive a little bit longer than necessary. Nobody coming over to help play hard and...
too big of a bomb to overcome the late game. Old 11 here is probably going to get coiled up. Coil expended,
yeah,
Wrath of Nature.
Easy double kill. Damage. They land the sweep. They should have the more than enough here to get the kill on Old 11, who is not really...
Prophet Orchid picked up already.
Coil again. Already going in on to Old 11 once more.
Wrath of Nature.
They will get the
it's
kill
just
on
too
Old
easy.
11 easily. They're using a lot though. Dreamcoil, Wrath of Nature both down, and now, well, Phonic Shield, that's going to purge off the silence that came in from the Orchid that was used by the Nature's Prophet. They're going to go in with a Well Response as well as the Tag Team, but they end up losing Playhard. Remnant over now towards the Elder Titan and back over to the side. Can they get anything more from this? No, they can't. Ori's gone, and it's looking like after the borrowed time is up, so is his time of life. DY, he's dead, three gone on Vici. I don't think he's in the best spot in that fight.
Old 11 again?
11 once again.
Orchid
just can't find any space on the map.
Wow, I did not expect, you know, Neo to be able to shut him down this much.
Dreamcoil now used on the Monkey King. And look
at
the damage
no.
coming so quick. Poyoyo blown up.
It's it's a big problem here for VG coming into this
Chat,
game.
Chat, can we all high five? He said the line. Hands up, people.
Pango get called once more?
Yeah, Old 11 in a bad spot. They're going to get the kill here on the Pangolier. They'll take him out. DeBeal getting the kill on that one. And...
man, they're going to have such a hard time killing him.
Yeah, they really are. They're
going to go Spirit
after
just
Ori,
dead.
Blow him up.
They went to this traditional hard carry, you know? Maybe in trouble here? He can't purge off the silence.
Old 11. He's caught
nice
again.
Juke, though.
Ooh, Wrath of Nature. Is that the
Rolling
spot,
Thunder?
Though? I don't think so. Rolling Thunder might help him
Tipping
out, though. And the TP is successful. This time... he escapes.
And gone.
Oh, but PRIW not so fortunate. Oh, Dreamcoil used, but Dreamcoil not gonna land, and now they're gonna go after this Puck. They've got the Wukongs down.
Monkey hold them no
away.
One.
And it's just the Wukongs that's not gonna land on anybody anymore because the Puck got out of the circle. They're gonna look over with the BKBB Popeye Poyoyo going after Death. Who's moving forward on this Nature's Prophet. They already got the Kona Ori. They'll look over at Januel to try and maybe get a trade on this, but it's not looking like
they're
be trying to run, but gets slept up and woken. Vici in the grave right now.
I'll tell you what they're not doing. They're not slowing down at all. Gas, gas, gas here. The new theme song for this Neon team. Puck though, shackled up. No damage.
Saved via the snowball. They just don't have the damage to kill him off after they've gotten the lockdown. They'll look over at DY, who gets the borrowed time pop. Three-man
big trial.
Coming in with the BKBB pop by Poyoyo. Going after Playhard. They get the kill on Ori. They're going to look over as they end up losing Playhard. Old 11 falls. So does DY. Three heroes down to the side of Beachy. Right clicks coming in. Bloodstone
this
pop.
This spell knife's still too big.
Poyoyo is dead. Godlike here for Yopage as they will look for another one. PYW on the run, and he will just elude the side of Neon. They're in the Fuchsia badge right now. I forget the name of the badge, but they're on their fifth one. They're taking names.
Is that
they're
a big coil too?
And look at
wow!
That. Ori just getting blown up so quickly for the Wrath of Nature. They go after PYW. They look for the Windrunner. The snowball's in. The death is there. Death by name. Death by action. And when you start saying they have to have perfect this, perfect that, you're into the point where the Dota Plus graph probably looks like 2% or less.
Yeah.
Maybe.
And we're saying perfect, but even perfect might not be enough. That's the problem.
Dreamcore gets used. That's going to be on old 11 for probably the dozen time, or dozen? 12th? They're going to get the kill on old 11 regardless, and now they're going to look over now at this side of Beachy, and they
just gets blown up.
Poyoyo is just gone. They're going to snowball and look for more. Take out DY. Three heroes dead. They do all have buyback. They're going to buyback immediately on DY, but still, I just don't see them turning this around. Sleight of Fist, Searing Chains. Tusk, the only one got on the side of Neon, and they are diving the base.
Dang
it.
Wow.
Going to PYW. It's just not happening.
23 Bloodstone Charges. What a damage on the Nemesis Breath. He just dies.
Look at Yopage, man.
Too much damage, no health, no life, no chance.
That's what you got, no chance.
They're just GG'ing out, GG! Just
wow.
Like that.
Wow, they tap, that's it.
They're not even trying, yeah, but they're not disconnecting. I guess
they've
they're
called
just
GG,